From the moment I started reading and watching slice of life rom-coms, one particular series that was recommended to me again and again was none other than Horimiya. And in January of this year, I finally decided to start reading the manga, but then I also found out that this series was actually starting out as an anime as well. Hence, I initially watched the first couple of episodes of the anime, I was absolutely sold on it, and thereby I transitioned into the manga and I read the entirety of it, and now in March of 2021, this series is finally coming to an end. And because I'm a relatively new fan of the series, I think I can give my objective opinion upon the ending of Horimiya without the glasses of nostalgia, because yes, I did fall in love with the series, but I have some complaints in relation to the final chapter. It's not big, I'm not saying that the ending was quote-unquote disappointment, it was good in its own respect. It's certainly not the case that I disliked or hated the ending as such, it's just quite normal for me. It's not something extraordinary or out of the box for me, especially because I read some of the webcomics as well, and I know what happens in the future of the series past this particular ending point. So yeah, in this video you can also expect some webcomic spoilers as well. You have been warned. But with that being said, hello and welcome to UnderYZ. My name is Soham and today we are going to talk about the ending chapter of Horimiya, that is chapter 122. But before that, if you are new here, then please consider subscribing to our channel, since I do weekly anime and manga related content along with a bunch of other pop culture related stuff. Also, we are trying to hit 6,000 subscribers by the end of this month, so like and sub would be massively appreciated. With that being said, let's begin the video. Also, just a quick note guys, the final chapter of this series is indeed chapter 122, it's not 125. That is actually a problem which came about because of some wrong fan translations. A lot of the translations miss some of the timeskip stuff, they all were supposed to be a part of chapter 19 and 0.1 and 0.2 like that. So technically and chronologically, this chapter is indeed called chapter 122. And surprisingly enough, this chapter was rather deeply focused upon Miyamura, not the side of Hori. And I kinda do understand why this actually happens, because this chapter essentially shows us the transition that Miyamura has had since the beginning of the series and how he transitioned from a character and how he grew as a character. That's the most important point here. The growth aspect of the series, or rather the growth aspect of a character, is aptly put forth here in the final chapter of Horimiya. So what basically happens here is that there is a valedictory speech given by none other than Sengoku, and funnily enough, it is Miyamura who sneezes right at the moment he's about to start, and that is basically the main shenanigan of this chapter, and Miyamura is kind of chased around the school by an angry Sengoku. But at the same time, when he reaches the roof, he's kind of looking forward to his prior self, his other self, and they have a chat here and they basically confront each other in relation to their growth as a person, and in the end, Miyamura accepts his other half, or rather his prior self as such. This part was all about self-acceptance. I think that this was brilliantly put forward here, and this does not really need a lot of dialogues in my opinion, because the pictures here are self-explanatory, and overall I thought that this scene was really beautiful. And after this, we got scenes from most of the other characters, minor scenes but still scenes from the other characters, like the meeting of Toru and Sakura, and the meeting between Yuki and Yanagi, and basically how they're moving forward with their lives. And the entire thing basically reminds us of the high school graduation day. This particular trope, this particular cliche has been done with a lot of different series. We saw something like this in relation to Oregairu as well, and we saw something like this in relation to a number of different other high school based rom-coms as well. So this is not something entirely new, but the overall characterizations here were believable. As fans, yeah, we were kind of disappointed, we wanted to see some other relationships build up between say someone like Yuki and Toru, or maybe even Toru and Sakura or the other people, but it's kind of believable in my opinion, because the writer kind of wants to portray here that not everything happens in life in accordance to our wishes. It's not always that what we want we always will get. That is not actually the case with real life, and I think that is kind of aptly put forth here. And all the characters kind of bury down their grievances as well, and basically they want to move forward with their life. Moreover, there is also obviously the usual comedic element from the two father characters in the form of Kyosuke and Takeru, and they also reminisce about their childhood, and basically this was a very hilarious interaction in my opinion. Moreover, there is the usual Yasuda who is acting like a, you all know basically how he acts, so I don't even need to specify here. Thus, basically most of the characters have an interaction here. The only person who was kind of missing here was none other than Sawada. I really wanted to see her at the end, but I guess it's just not possible. And the last couple of pages are totally dedicated to the Horimiya couple, that is Hori as well as Miyamura. And this was really nice, this was really beautiful. We got an ample amount of flashback in relation to some of the most important scenes which they have had up until this moment. And this was a pretty good moment, and in the end they are basically looking forward to the new future. And also this is the end of the road for us the readers, but this is just a starting for them for the couple of Horimiya, so best wishes for them. Now coming to the last part of this video, I was kind of disappointed in one major aspect, and that is the fact that we did not get any future scenes whatsoever, any kind of a time skip scene, nothing of that sort was actually hinted here. And after spoiling myself with the webcomics, I'm kind of disappointed with that. We should have at least got a marriage scene. I'm not even asking about the kids part, but just a marriage scene would have been really enough. But I guess this is the way in which the manga wanted to end itself, so it's fine, I guess. Overall, the chapter was really fine in my opinion. I can't say that it was extremely brilliant or extremely bad. For me, this was just fine. Yes, sure, there were some good moments here and there, but overall this was a pretty normal chapter, and I cannot consider it to be the quote-unquote best chapter of all time. That is not even the case for this series in itself, because there were much better chapters overall in this particular series, but I guess since this is a slice of life rom-com, so it's pretty alright as an ending. Moreover, this is only a speculation, but when the final volume of the series is actually released sometime in the summer, there is likely going to be volume extra chapters in it, so maybe, just maybe, we can hope or we can expect to see some sort of a time skip or some sort of a future scene in there. Once again, this is just a speculation, but this is not baseless because the webcomics actually did not end at this particular moment. There were more stuff in relation to the other characters as well, in relation to Shota and how he grew up, and as such we can maybe expect to see some sort of a time skip in the future of this series. But overall, for the grand scheme of the things, I'm a huge fan of this series and I'm so glad that I actually got to read it before its eventual ending. Overall, the ending was not a very huge deal for me, but I'm not really saying that I was disappointed as such. For me, this was an alright ending, and I guess it's not bad. And there were some very good moments here and there sprinkled in the last chapter as well. So these were some of my quick thoughts in relation to the last chapter, the final chapter of Horimiya, and this is my ending explained for y'all. So what do you guys think about all of this? Please mention your thoughts in the comment section below. So that's it for today guys, thank you so much for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like it, share it with your friends, and subscribe to our channel for more. Also, please do join the channel membership for some very cool perks and features. This is WonderYZ, and I'll see you soon in the next one.